Your team set a Bray era record and tied the school record for assists with 33 assists tonight. I would imagine you saw what you wanted to see.
What a difference a couple days makes, yeah. Huh? You know, we've led the nation in assist to turnover without even shooting it very well, which tells you we're really a good passing team. And that was just beautiful to watch, playing the game the right way, sharing it, moving it. And I think we've all known we've got better shooters than the numbers have shown. And I'm hoping this is a breakthrough, you know, for us offensively. But, you know, it's we needed a game like this. I thought we prepared Sunday and Monday to play better and be more focused after a disappointing Saturday. But, boy, do we have an opportunity this Saturday.
Yes. Coach, certainly talk about the 33 assists, 20 made three-point field goals, getting it from all sorts of guys. You got to feel good. It looked like some guys were stepping up with more confidence today.
Yeah, and we really talked about that and addressed that. You know, we've had some of our younger guys turn shots down. Like, they're good shooters. Rise up and take it. And we have such good passers, and we're so unselfish. I mean, again, 33 assists. There's some teams that could play 5-on-0 for 2 hours and not get 33 assists. I mean, I'm so pleased that we play the right way, and we delivered with some open looks tonight. So, hope again, maybe we can think back to the Detroit game as a breakthrough for us offensively.
Prentice Hubb with his first double-double, 11 assists, 13 points. But I'm not sure you can be more efficient on offense than Dane Goodwin was. In this game, he scored 27 points to tie Antoine Davis, who's third in the country in scoring, but he scored 27 points on 13 shots.
You know, I know he was very disappointed on Saturday, and I had him come in on Sunday. I said, how can I help you? What's up? You didn't even compete on the defensive end. He said, you need to be on me more. I said, okay, be ready. And so when he was in the midst of his run, he was smiling. I said, it's about time. And we'll stay on him. So, yeah, he is a gifted offensive guy and can come in and put numbers up. And so can Nate. And I thought for him tonight was a good night. Those guys have great strokes. If they got open looks, you better just don't turn them down. Let it fly.
Well, speaking of let it fly, the one that Nate hit in the second half where he streaks to the corner, yeah. Kind of doesn't have perfect balance, but gets it up, shoots it really confidently. Reminds me of the shot against the Toledo to send it into overtime.
And he just needs to think of himself like that on every release. Don't be reluctant and wonder if it's a good shot. If you can get it off, like the Toledo out of bounds, if you can get it off over the top of a guy, it's a good shot for you. You have a beautiful stroke. So, again, they're learning. We got some young guys that are learning, but tonight was a good night for us to do.
How about your rebounding? Dane Goodwin, again, 7 rebounds. He had 4 assists, 2 steals. But your entire squad rebounded well, and that is something else that you need to do.
Yeah, I mean, you can't just have Johnny do it all. I thought Juwan Durham was really just knows who he is. He's playing around the bucket. He makes his free throws. He blocks shots. He rebounds. You know, it's a group. You know, they have played together a while now, and the rotation is smaller, but they all know they're going to play. And they're getting to know each other a little better. So, again, we certainly need it tonight. And if we can get Saturday, it'd be a really good week going into exams.
Do you still sense the specialness of this rivalry with UCLA? Because you grew up watching it as well. And, you know, the whole country is going to be watching it because it is Notre Dame-UCLA.
No, this is really neat for our guys to be part of it in this building. Bill Walton doing the game. I know Digger's going to be here and get on TV a little bit with him. And there's great, great memories, certainly, from the 88. But as I was talking about the history of the rivalry, TJ in there interrupted me and said, nah, Coach, we owe them. Because they at the buzzer last year in Los Angeles, they took our heart. I said, yeah, forget the history. Let's just get a win.
Thank you.
Thank you.